Welcome back to Let's Play Daggerfall, Unity, Blind, The Elder Scrolls 2, etc. I am Amethyst Lunatari, here with starting episode 70 now, where we made quite a bit of changes. You might be able to tell right from here. I can tell right away because I always hear this when I start the game. The music's changed. I'm going to get into that, and we were running version 0.11.4, now we're on 0.13.4. Been a lot of changes to this. It's a new version of the Unity engine itself, and I notice it's a lot smoother. I'll show you guys. At least it seems that way to me, moving around and such. And yeah, it made changes with the lighting, some changes with graphics, rendering, stuff like that. A lot of real technical stuff. And I also installed a whole bunch of mods. So, get into that. I also uninstalled some things. This is what I'm most excited about. 3D enemies. We're finally getting into, guys, having not sprites, but 3D characters, NPCs. These are the enemies, though. These are monsters. I think it doesn't include the humanoids. They look the same to me, but I went back and played through a little bit of the... See, yeah, the music doesn't loop. They're going to change that. Getting into the music in a bit. They changed... I went back, loaded old save, went back to Privateer's Hold. The rats are different. They're actually 3D models. The bats look pretty freaking cool, especially how the wings flap, animate, and stuff like that. Because it's very unrealistic. Bats would have to flap a lot faster, but that's not the Daggerfall way. They flap slow. And the freaking... Pardon my language. I said freaking. The skeletons, the skeletal warriors, look amazing. Especially how they, when they, you know, swing their weapon. I freaking love it. And that's the only ones I've seen so far. I'm going to be happily surprised, hopefully, by other enemies, monsters we come across. So, there's no description. Thank you, John Doom and Ninilan. Thank you for, Gaven Interkarma for working on the new version, and King of Worms for the updated Dream 2022 version 1.0. Updated that. A lot of these mods I've updated. I'm not really going to get into that, but this is new. This is the actions framework. This can be used during quests. So I needed this for two other mods that I installed, required actions framework. So that's that. Archaeologist still here. Basic roads. Here's the animator or animation framework. That's required for the 3D enemies. So as an animator, you have to have that installed as well. So that's new. We still have that. Aquatic sprites, that's new. I've newly installed that. There's a few, before I forget them, that won't show up in here because they're not DF mods. Only the DF mod files will show up in here. The music is called Orchestral and Acoustic Remaster of Daggerfall Soundtrack by Lord Braithen. All one word, L-O-R-D. Braathen. I'm running version 1.1.2. I think the upcoming version, I believe 1.2, he's going to have the music actually loop. I might deactivate this just because the music just stops. At least here it did, and hopefully it'll continue sometimes. Just, we have nothing here. I like to keep having new music. And what's the other one that doesn't show up? Mm. DFU quest pack, quest pack, DFU quest pack 2 by JH. That's version 2022.02.10. So that. And just quickly going off what we have here. Prison Daggerfall, convenient clock, convenient quest log, sky shards, a lot of these just didn't update. Decorator, distant terrain. I'm trying to remember what new ones there were. I just re-downloaded them all. There were only a few that I dragged over, and I ended up deactivating some of those. As you'll see, we've deactivated airships. If I have airships activated, the game loads up with a black blank screen. You can hear it running. There's music, there's sound, and stuff like that. But just there's no graphic. The monitor's like, might as well be off. So, we had to, you know, turn that off. Dream has updated. This is brand new. I think December 24th of 2021 this came out. So this is new. Enhanced sky. Hand paint models. Hotkey bar. I believe this updated to something. Fixed dungeon exteriors. Yeah, this is new. This, yeah, changes hundreds of dungeon exterior to fit their theme. Less cave mounds exteriors, more variety. I approve. Hotkeys of various actions. Yeah, I'm not sure what was, I don't remember what was added there. This is hand repainted pictures. Improved interior lighting ahead. Loading screen. I believe that updated with a new version. Don't quote me on that. NPC health indicators, persistent dungeons. If you guys want more info on what these things do, refer back to my Daggerfall Part 0. I go into all this. Ready spellcasting hands. You can see the spellcasting hands sticking out. Real grass, roleplay realism. Sneak and crouch combined. This is a new one I added. Sneaking and crouching is one single action. I really just did that for you guys so you guys can tell when I'm sneaking, so it's like Skyrim type sneaking. You crouch and sneak at the same time. Either button will do. I can press my sneak button, I can press my crouch button, and I'll sneak and crouch, either one. So, taverns redone already, had travel options I had. Don't really use. Trees of Daggerfall, Vibrant Wind, Villager Immersion Overhaul. This is outdated version. If I run with this enabled, the game crashes, so I had to disable that. Quite a lot of, downloading the new edition, getting Dream, which was like, Dream is like almost 4 gigs now to download. Insane. It's so worth it. And, then just doing a few mods at a time. Okay, I crashed. I could take some off. You know, just troubleshooting and figuring out which ones work and which don't. The other one that doesn't even show up here, I didn't bother putting it in just to have it deactivated. Post-processing is a mod I had installed. I did not bring that over to the new version because it's no longer needed. It's part of the Dream mod now. Well, the Dream mod does the same thing. Either one. So, fixed dungeon exteriors and 3D enemies actions framework. Wildlife. Yeah, that's over here. World tooltips we still have. Wildlife. Yeah, there's a bunch of John Doom. Thanks, John Doom. Adding animals in the wilderness. I think they don't attack you. It's, you know, you'll just come across a random cow or a dog or something like that. The same you would in town. So, and yeah, it seems like a lot more than I, lot more installed than I did. I mean, including the animator and action framework. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 9 new mods installed. 3 are either removed or deactivated. Pretty awesome. And now, down the bottom here, it says King of Worms, Dream 2022 version. I think that's supposed to be 1.0. It looks like it says version 10. But, yeah, let's see. I gotta change my recording setup a little bit. I'll see you guys in the game. Okay, so I still wanted to show you guys when I load. It says the currently used mods do not match the ones used by the save. Airship, not loaded because I deactivated. Dream is updated to new version, so it's gonna say that for all the Dream parts. Hotkey bar has been altered. Yeah, it's no longer 010. I was right. Villager immersion overhaul, not loaded. Post-processing, not loaded. Those are the ones I've deactivated with post-processing I didn't even put in. Taverns redone, dream patch. I didn't put that in because I think we don't need the dream patch anymore. I don't know. So proceed, yes. And now we got the loading screen. Terrain sampler. Yeah, they changed my position, so I'm no longer outside the castle, but this is still Daggerfall. I'm just outside because I changed things so much, or things have changed so much. So it just seems smoother, you know? But inside, looks much the same. I think it looks more colorful, doesn't it? Well, they did something with the roofs of the houses look different. It's a better, like, get up there. They changed. Well, we've got an overhang. I can't climb. Oh, yes, I can. The texture's been redone. Where's your kitty? Hello, kitty. Pet the kitty. It's still a sprite kitty. Only the monsters, I believe, will be changed to 3D. It looks so good, though. I mean, it's not like, you know, anything. To me, it's amazing. But it's not like AAA, if that's what you guys think. So I'm going to go meet the Necromancers. Lady Bridwell in Daggerfall is letting me claim an artifact. I must visit the Homonochexa Hole and meet a messenger from the Necromancers there. I have 40 days. Plenty of time. I'm just going to do my little thing. Actually, I have to rebind my keys. I have that, but I don't have it hotkeyed. There's my hotkeys. Yeah, all blank. So, unfortunately, we can't bind that. Can't map the buckler. We can map the steel longbow of featherweight. So, now I can switch between. Don't hit the nice man. Alright, so I'm going to do my little thing. Always trying to get that restoration up. And hopefully we won't crash like we have been. Now that I've deactivated that, that might have been the culprit all along. Just couldn't figure it out. Because at that point, it was random. Sometimes things would load up just fine, sometimes not. This time it was easier because the game would crash every time I had it loaded. It's a villager immersion overhaul. It's an old version that needs to be updated. I think even before we updated to this 0.13.x, you know, fill in the blank, whichever ones. I think even before that, it had to be updated. So now, we have ports. So I wish to travel. Yeah, it's gonna go right there. You know what? I hope I go. Ports will show us. Okay. This actually shows us which towns are port towns. Including where I just was. These aren't ports, I don't think. These are like little ponds or lakes or something. Alright, so let's just go back now. Wait. It's not working now? Wait. Is that a bug? It won't work. Hamuna Chexa. Yeah, okay. Hold up. Been a while. Not resting. B, right? Okay. Hamuna. So it's out. It's not in Daggerfall. Why won't it let me? Is it because I have ports? Maybe I need to turn it back off. It could have been because I had ports selected. Alright. Travel. Yes. Okay, so now... It doesn't show up. We're supposed to have an option to teleport there. That might be something I have to configure separately. An option to teleport there by the Mage's Guild for a price. That was added to travel options. I have travel options installed, don't I? Ugh. I have to quit out to check it. I'll check it another time. So cautiously foot my horse short. The air seems cooler here. Something about a breeze ruffling my hair. You come across a traveler resting on a tree stump. That would be you. What? Whoa! Whoa! Well, the tigers need to be animated a little better. Oh, there they go. Oh, they randomly will run and then slide like that. Alright, guys. Work on the tigers. I'm more worried about the tigers killing me now. I mean, it's hard to tell sometimes because they run at you no matter... Ow. No matter where you are, so... You can't see the back of the sprites, stupid things. Not the sprites, the 3D models. Well, they need to run every time and stop sliding like that. Well, I almost got one. Get it. 3 points. Come on. Yes. You know what? And I've been thinking about. I hope the Thief Just Died will show up sometimes. I'd be sad if that didn't happen. We need Thief to just be dying every time. Or at least often. Where's your... I guess that other one's undamaged. Owie! I've had enough of your interloperness. I didn't mean to do that. Same button. No treasure on these things, huh? I thought they carried, like, little flowers and stuff like that. I guess sometimes they do. I'm heading to Tamkar to look for work. How about you? You're not gonna heal me? What good are you? You're a healer. I wouldn't think these would have any treasure. I think maybe I get like a saber tooth tusk or something out of them. Alright, so it's supposedly not going to look like a mound with a hole in it. It can look like something else. Oh boy, that was different. I like it though. Where's the entrance to this place? That almost looked like a path. That looks like a path. Wait, what? Am I supposed to be looking for a path? Thief just died. I'm gonna keep saying it anyway, guys. It's just not a Daggerfall experience for me if Thief doesn't die. Okay. So it's just alternating between some different forms of music for the area. Doesn't last very long. I don't know where I'm supposed to be going. Where's the entrance to this dungeon? A stream gurgles nearby. A spring bubbles from the ground. Stuff does stuff. Other stuff does other stuff. The end. Maybe over here? I don't know what I'm looking for. It says a fortress? Is it actually an... I don't see anything around here that looks like that. The homina checks a hole. Is it gonna actually look like a hole? A dark breeze ruffles your hair. Waiting for more monsters. So since the dungeon exteriors mod has been loaded, is apparently working. I wonder if we are just looking for a hole. Because I haven't seen these exteriors. I'm still playing this blind. Once we get on here, the music changes. I'm not sure if that means anything. That whole tree is moving. That's awesome. Look at that. Is that significant? These trees move a lot. Never noticed that. I'm looking for the entrance to this dungeon. Hail! Oh, I clicked that and then that happened. Hail, friend. I was just on my way to Raywest. Didn't mean to startle you. I'll be on my way then. May Lord Akatosh lend you his might. That's poor grammar. I'm clicking it. Okay, no one else is talking. It almost looked like a path. Is that supposed to be guiding me towards the dungeon? One more random flavor text. I can't find this dungeon, guys. I don't see it. I mean, I don't know if you would normally... You know what? Begin. Okay. So you figure... You know, if there was something like an entrance to a dungeon, you figure it would be on the map, but... Let's travel south. Maybe this is it. It still looks like a hole. Well, I guess this is something, like maybe this is supposed to look like a hole. Alright, so now I'm in sneak and crouch mode both. Well, I finally found it. Oh, wow. I don't know if I can hit him this far away. Ha ha! I can. And I did. Oh, look, there's an orc up there. Look at it with the wings flapping. Right, switch over. Look at it. That's awesome. Oh, it is flapping a little faster, sometimes anyway. I don't know where I'm going. I'm so amazed by this thing. That's a 3D model. I'm just letting it hit me. You're beautiful and I love you, but you're trying to kill me, so I'm gonna have to defend myself. Apologize for that. Oh. I do see you up there. I hit him. Throw that blood. Don't worry, guys. You'll be able to see the models. What does this do? Does this lead us to a way down? I don't know what that did. Oh, it moves that across. Oh, that's interesting. Do I want that to be like that? Oh, yeah. Okay, so then we could just walk right across there. Awesome. I like that. I think we go a little slower also. I want a mod that takes off the random environmental noises of doors, because I always think they're actual doors opening and closing, like an arena. Can someone set that up for me? I'd really appreciate it. Alright, let's go down this... let's just look over here. That goes up, right? Now let's go up. There's two ways down, we're going up first. So what am I supposed to be finding here? I gotta meet the necromancers. Or meet a messenger from the necromancers. And kill monsters. In that order of priority. Ah, oh, you've seen me. The jig is up. Not sure if I ever heard him hit the ground with such a sound like that. And to me, the sound of this is a little louder, like a little more dynamic, I think. Coming from different sides of the, you know, I hear it coming from, because I'm wearing headphones, I'm hearing it come from one hit, from one ear to the other, kind of thing. Cool. And that's what. Let's look for a hidden door or something over here. Whoop! It is! Let's go see what's in here first. Hmm. Absolutely nothing. Why would you. I'm clicking the walls here. Why would you have a hidden door? It's probably a random dungeon then. I'm guessing this is not a handcrafted dungeon? Could be wrong, but why would you put a hidden door with, like, just nothing in it? And what is this? Oh, no. Oh. Those gold pieces look like a letter. It was a piece of paper with gold pieces on it. Like that. There's another one. Guess I'll take the steel stuff. The arrows. Not sure it even tried shooting arrows at me. I was so far away. I guess my skills with the bow are getting a little better. Who would have thought? Going back down. Anyone hiding down there? Now that looks different. But then again, I am still playing this and coming across things I have never seen before. Well, you've seen me, haven't you? Yeah. We need a little more detail for that model. It looks pretty cool, though. I like the claws. Ouch. I didn't like the claws at that point. Guess it's hard to sneak up on a grizzly bear. I wonder if that's the case. It's easier to sneak up on some monsters than others. Definitely between the lighting, I could see, got a punch to it. That, and the music, and the 3D models for these creatures. How do I switch to steel mode? It does not unlock. Grab mode. Empty. Apparently. Nothing. Nothing, nothing. Cobweb, look at that. I don't recognize that sound. What is that? I guess we're gonna see it in 3D first. New monster. Maybe it's a spriggan. Wait. I came from this way. Oh, no. I didn't. Are you a ghoul? I am too far away. Well, I don't like you very much. Tell you that much. I'm not hitting you. Hmm. 56. Maybe that's why I wasn't hitting it. I was hitting the too close to the ledge. One more. Okay, screw it. Because you keep making saves, I'll use minor bolt so as not to waste my mana. Oh, it's a zombie. As the zombie falls, it groans a strangely human word.
Letter.
What? Did this creature just speak?